All right, what's up, guys? Blake Hawthorne, It's His Turf. Today, I want to talk to you about what we're doing with our lawn maintenance guys, just to ensure that they stay steady through the winter. And what we've done is we taught them how to build privacy fences. Our guys that never built one, this is their first one they built. It's really nice. I'll show you a few of the really simple things we did just to make sure it looked high end. Just a few little tricks we do. One thing is this 1x4 and this 1x6 cap that we like to put on them, and just really dresses it up. When we were digging our holes, we dug our posts. We got 8-foot 4x4s and we dug our holes 18 inches deep. We actually hit a couple water lines on this because it went right in line with all of our holes. So like I said, we set those posts on 10-foot centers, and then we went ahead and we put them 18 inches in the ground. This roughly took about one bag of Quikrete per bag. It was a little cold and it actually took a couple days to set up. Your wall, your post and everything, they're gonna be a little bit loose, and so what you wanna do is once the fence is all tied together, especially once that other side comes in, then it's gonna sturdy up your fence. So don't worry if you got a little bit of give. Once these 2x4s start to go on there, it'll start to sturdy it up. Once the dog ears go on there, it sturdies it up even more. So when you're bidding this, I have it broke down to per linear foot. Guys, I can bid this just by knowing how many gates they want, how many corners they want, and how many linear feet. I actually placed a bid the other day over the phone. Customer called me, told me how many feet it was. I gave them a price right then and there. But when you're pricing it out, guys, you want to figure in for 1 6-foot 4x4, 3 10-foot 2x4s. On the 10-foot 2x4s, you got to be careful. They should be like 10-foot 2 inches. And if you don't keep your post directly in center, you're gonna end up short. But if you do it right, you should be able to buy 10 footers, put them center of the 4x4s, and that way they butt up against each other across the entire back. Then, like I said, per 10-foot section, take that 10-foot, multiply it by 12 inches, get 120 inches, divide it by 5.5, and that'll give you how many pickets you have per section. And then 1 1x4 and 1x6. We went 16 footers on these, but you guys can do 10 footers, 12s, whatever. We just knew we were gonna be going a long span and we didn't have to have 10 footers. It'll actually be better if you use 12 or 16 footers because you're gonna be overlapping each of your sections, just creating that strength at each of those transitions at the post. All right, so this right here is the strength I was telling you guys about, is this corner. That really strengthens the fence, so you don't see the wobbling that you get where if you were gonna go down there towards the other end and go to shake it, it doesn't have this terminal corner post, and so you get a little bit of that give. Bidding a fence like this, if I wasn't gonna put the decorative top on it, I could probably get $12 to $14 a foot, but going ahead and putting this top on there, going a little extra, I'm able to get around $17 a foot for the fencing. Now this includes the terminal post that you'll have to include. Now if you're just gonna price it out on materials, don't forget that when you're doing 10-foot sections, that on the center of each 10-foot, you have another post. So if you just space that out, you're gonna be one post short on the end. So what we did is we came out here, we set all of our posts, we ran a string line from one end down to the other, and then we picked, there was a little bit of a grade difference in here, so we ran to that post, we pulled our string line, we cut all these off, so we picked the shortest post, we checked it, it actually happened to be like 6-foot 2 inches, so that's the one that we picked. We ran everything at 6 foot off of that, gave us a real nice clean edge across the top. Down here you see we had to make a grade change, so we came down 10 foot to that post and then strung our string line across to the other post. Just get that nice clean look. Also, by putting this cap on there, you have a nice edge to follow instead of those dog ears. This little bit of extra goes a long way. It's a nice little upsell. Like I said, guys, my team had never done this before and we were able to come out here, have them set posts. But we set the 2x4, showed them what to measure the 2x4s on centers, and they laid everything out. And then we started running the dog ear. The one thing when you're running the dog ear, you want to use a little torpedo level to make sure that these pickets are staying level, because this edge is not always level, so you'll start to get off. You want to make sure that, other than that, guys, it's really simple. We use nails in our pickets and we use screws on all of our 2x4s and our caps. What we'll do on the backside, I like to use ring shank, because that way they won't pull out. But you can also use 1.5-inch screws. I would charge a little bit more if the customer wanted to do that. I give them that option, just that way they don't pull out. But the ring shank, they hold in tight. If you don't use nails that are ring shank or screws, what you'll see is you're gonna see that they start to pull out and separate, and you're gonna be in here doing a lot of repair. So spend a little bit extra money, do ring shank or do screws. That way it's not separating. You don't have to come back here and do repair on it. It's cheap security. Also, like I said, team had never done it before. We just did a real quick section, two sections with them, and they finished this whole fence out on their own. There's just a few things we had to reiterate, like keeping the pickets level that they were getting off on. But other than that, we showed them what distance to space on the 2x4s, how to lay out the pickets, keeping those level, and then we ran a string line for them already, so they just had to put the top of the picket each time to that string line. It took them a little over a day to do this, but not ever doing it before, I was super happy. So guys, not only are we able to teach them another trade, another tool for their arsenal, as I like to say, but we're also allowing to give them some winter work. This isn't something that you'll see me selling a bunch of in the summer. Maybe if they're one of my clients, we'll do some repairs and whatnot. But it's a great thing this time of the year to be able to offer and to go ahead and do. Lawn maintenance is still my bread and butter, but this is definitely something that the guys had a lot of fun doing this time of the year. And it's a nice change of scenery. Next week, we're gonna come out here. We're gonna be putting in the pergola. That'll be another thing we'll teach our guys. I'll make a video for you as well. Hope you enjoyed today's video. Saw something, another thing that we're doing this winter to just keep our guys busy, keep that cash flow going, and just holding on till spring. So I hope you enjoyed. God bless. Have a great day.